Welcome to the second map between Grubby and Lil DC. We're on Twisted Meadows. Grubby is leading 1-0, and Lil DC needs to win two maps in a row to maintain his chances to stay in the tournament. Grubby needs to win this map or the next one to maintain his chances in the tournament, and afterwards Todd has to beat Fire to keep whoever wins this best of three in the tournament. So Grubby with Altar first in pink in the bottom left corner, and Barracks, I imagine. Yes. And LDC with Altar first as well. Moonwell and an Ancient of War in front of the Null camp. This time with a Null Overseer and two Null Wardens instead of two Null Assassins. And let's see if Grubby is gonna wanna get aggressive immediately again. I'm guessing his scouting pattern is going to give us some clue of what his early game approach is going to be. I'm assuming Blade Master by the Orc. And Demon Hunter by the Night Elf. Not largely surprising, of course. Scout has not yet. Ah, okay, of course. There's the scout. He has left the base, and if he goes here and then immediately over here to continue scouting, I'm assuming he's gonna wanna get aggressive. If he doesn't, then it's going to more. Excuse me. It's going to be more of a passive early approach. Barracks finished. First grunt coming. Second burrow coming. Okay, and he scouts the spawn positions actually, so not just going for the Ancient of War spots early on. And yeah, heroes soon to come out, second Moonwell as well by LDC, building it like he did on Secret Valley in front of the forest to protect the Harvesting Wisps. Blade Master is out, so is the Demon Hunter. Again, no shot by Grubby before he starts his tech. And is he actually... No, he's gonna get aggressive. Nevertheless, the timing is still okay for Grubby. He sees that there is no Ancient of War here, and therefore... Yeah, therefore he's gonna go for the harassment. Once again, the Null Overseer is going to lead DC. I think he's heard this. Therefore, he's pulling back the Ancient of War. The Wisp should be not detonated. Okay, so first XP for Grubby. Demon Hunter is coming in. Didn't get a mana burn in. Therefore, Grubby is going to have one more Windwalk after this. The Grunt is actually going towards the main base, but as the DH is heading back, he's not going to do any Wisp harassment for the moment. But the Blade Master is going to be able to pick off the first of the Null Wardens. Second one, perhaps as well. He's got one more Windwalk, as I said previously. He can use that any second if he wants to. Doesn't keep the... okay, he keeps the Grunt fairly close. Just to make sure the Demon Hunter doesn't get this Null Warden finished for free. Keeping the Blade Master at a safe distance from Mana Burn. And he might be forced to use that in just a second, which he's doing right now. Demon Hunter is heading back towards the remainders of the Orange Camp. Blade Master is doing the same thing. Let's see if the Demon Hunter is going to try and get the Mana Burn in here in time. But he's not going to be able to do so. The Grunts are finishing off the second Null, and therefore... Basically, similar early game than previously. Let's see if the LDC is gonna lose his Demon Hunter level 1 once again in an attempt to kill a low level creep. I'm assuming he's not going to do so, but this time Hunter's Hall by LDC, who's halfway through his tech already, continues chasing the one grunt. The base is open at one spot here, so Grubby should be able to keep the Demon Hunter out. I mean, of course, it's open here as well. But keeping the Demon Hunter out here for a moment is already easily enough to maintain the Grunt here, as it still had plenty of HP to work with. So Boots and Dust for the Blade Master, Boots and no Dust for the Demon Hunter. Blade Master is gonna get in here, cancel the shop pretty easily. And other than that, LDC is again getting a couple of archers here. Shop being rebuilt. Grubby, looks like he wanted to finish the Wisp with a Windwalk. Doesn't get the chance to do so. Moon Choose used in time. Blade Master has to get going. And the shop is going to be built once again. So, three grunts are out. Blade Master of Grubby is going to go to the shop. Get four grunts, actually. Get heal salves. And this time on tier 2, let's see if Grubby is going to go for the Shadowhunter again, or if he's going to go for more of a regular late-game approach. Another Grunt is taking plenty of damage here. And it is nothing yet. One beast tree for Grubby so far. And nothing else. He does not have resources to build a second hero yet. And actually this time LDC is able to pick off a few creeps. Beastmaster second has been bought. Let's see how much damage he's going to be able to do here. One of the Saths gets cancelled. Grunt should be able to get back. Oops. Should be able to get back into safety though. One of the archers taking a little bit of damage, but being pulled back rather early. There's no mana for the Blade Master. So continuing the chase here could turn out to be quite expensive, but the archers are turning around. So doing Grubby a favor here. That's probably going to secure him the kill on one of them if he uses Dust. Yes, he does, but he doesn't have a heal staff remaining, so that's quite painful for him. He's got to retreat. The second archer is taking some damage, has to retreat right now as well. Let's see how well he's going to be able to block here. Pretty well, actually, with the Quill Beast. Grubby, in the meantime, gets heal staffs, using the Speed Scroll to get both the Blade Master and the Grunt into safety. And a second Beast Tree by him is what we see here, so no Spirit Lodge. And Demon Hunter... yeah, continues the chase. Speed Scroll has run out. Actually, the Grunt is probably still going to fall. But at least that bought Grubby the time for both of his Beast Trees to come up. And the Shadowhunter second is going to be out soon as well. And the Grunt survived. And LDC continues to show off his blocking skills. So with that, he's doing a really good job. The Grunt probably is going to suicide. XP is not going to LDC here as the Ogre Mauler is dealing the final blow to get the Grunt killed. One Ancient of Lore already up. Second one coming as well. Immediately, Adept upgrade for the Bears is being researched. This Ancient of Lore is probably going to be cancelled here as the Grunt is joining the Blade Master right now in his endeavor to get the building killed. Shadowhunter has spawned. And the Ancient of Lore, yeah, that one is going to have to be cancelled. Blade Master is taking a bit of damage in return. LDC, is he going to get the block here once again? Yes, he does, but just for a second. Not enough to get the Blade Master killed entirely. Still at 60 HP. Shadowhunter did pick up heal salves, so he's going to be able to get some health back on that one. And the Ancient of War has gotten a little bit too ambitious here. Okay, another little block there by LDC, who's got his wisps everywhere. Fortunately, the Baitmaster didn't die, because I would have perhaps missed that. The Ancient of War is going to fall in front of the Mercenary camp, so that is going to set back LDC by quite a bit. And Grubby is continuing to keep up the pressure here. And yeah, one Ancient of War still only is up. This one has not been cancelled manually by LDC, so wasting a lot of resources here. One of the Moonlights is even in trouble already, as two raiders are battering down on it. And Hex on the Demon Hunter. Ancient of Wonders is falling. Blade Master is pretty low. Continues poking in here. But LDC's got nothing on the field yet, because he's suffering so much from these Ancients of Lore cancels. One of the raiders is falling. Demon Hunter has to Town Portal though. Still only one bear out, one rejuvenation for the moment on the Demon Hunter. And LDC has no map presence at the moment. As soon as he comes out here, he's gonna get ensnared, he's gonna get surrounded by this way superiorly sized orc army. And therefore Grubby might just be striking the perfect timing here. He continues to go for the Ancient of Lore. LDC has got a few wisps, but they're coming in way too late. The Ancient of Lore is definitely going to fall. And LDC's got no production left. Hex on the Druid of the Claw. Dispel getting rid of that. But still there is on Snare and Snare on it. Another Ancient of Lore is being built. The Druid of the Claw is falling. The Archer could be falling soon as well. The Ancient of Lore has to be cancelled immediately. Grubby's taking a decent load of damage on all of his units. But with the Ensnare available, with the Speed Scroll, and with the tiny damage output of LDC at the moment, there's no way in hell that LDC can finish off any unit. So Grubby is retreating. It's 22 supply for LDC. He's building, rebuilding one Ancient of Lore, rebuilding his shop. And yeah, what is the plan right now? The problem is he just used his town portal. He cannot go out on the map because he's got two heroes and one unit. But at the same time, if he sits back, things aren't going to get better for him as well. And Grubby is coming in again. Three grunts, three raiders. Now the Quill Beast canceling staffs here. The grunts are pulling back in time. But yeah, Lily C. He's gonna have a tough time holding this. Second Ancient Floor is being rebuilt. But the Orc Army is here. To continue with this pressure. One Moonwell down. 25 out of 30 for Lily C. Shop finished. Maybe can at least get an Orb and Potion. Maybe Moonstone, okay. Well, Moonwells do have plenty of mana. So I guess there could be other priorities. Once again, the shop is being taken down. Lily C is... I did get the orb on the Beastmaster beforehand. No staff though, no new town portal, no nothing. Three raiders available to keep the ensnare on the Demon Hunter. He does so. Demon Hunter is going down and the lone Beastmaster has to defend here against 48 supply of Orc Army. He's going to get surrounded as well. The one raider might fall here if Grabby doesn't pull him back. The lone archer is being devoured by the Kodo. The Quill Beast actually finishes off the Raider, but that is the last unit Lee DC is going to kill in this tournament. He's been dominating in the group stage. He's been doing well against Fire, but against the big two, against Grubby and against Todd, he did not stand a chance. He is out of the tournament. He is, didn't get anywhere close in these two games. Grubby in this one, once again, in time to distract or basically to punish Lily C for the Ancient of War creep early on. Once again, he killed the two, the two Gnoll Wardens. Last game, it was the two Gnoll Assassins. Killed a Wisp early on. The Demon Hunter didn't really get too much done. Lily C showed off some nice blocking, but actually it did not secure him a single unit kill. Just got him a lot of damage dealt against Grubby's units, and then things just kinda started piling on. He wasted a lot of time on tier 2 when he got his Beastmaster to try and chase down grunts instead of delaying Grubby's tech buildings, and he didn't get a single one killed, whereas Grubby got the one Ancient of Lore delayed, and he came in with the perfect timing. The Ancient of War was just going down to creeps. Imagine if he had been able to creep that to get mercenaries to help defend against Grubby's early push and to help maintain his Ancient of Lore. Things could have looked way differently, but he didn't. He had very little units to defend. He was able to defend it once, but without really killing anything, and at the cost of his shop and both his Ancient of Lore, and he had nothing remaining at that point. He was trying to rebuild. Grubby was coming in again for the kill. In a very dominating fashion, taking both of these maps, and therefore he is going to maintain his chances here. So he's winning 2-0. That means he's up at 3 points right now with a map score of 4-4. Fire is up at 3 points with a map score of 3-3. So the scenario where both of them end up with the same points and the same map score cannot take place anymore. Grubby would have had to win 2-1 for that to still be a possibility. So it's going to be very simple, a best of three between Todd and Fire. If Fire wins, he's in the top four. If Todd wins, Grubby is in the top four. So that's all there is to say for this best of three. I hope you're looking forward to Fire against Todd. I hope you enjoyed this one. As always, thumbs up, subscribe, comment, and I see you for the next best of three. Bye.